The 30th anniversary of the Rainbow Warrior bombing is approaching. The vessel used for campaigning against nuclear testing was bombed twice and sunk by two French operatives in the Port of Auckland in 1985. To mark the occasion, journalism and television students from the Auckland University of Technology have started on a storytelling project this week. Journalism major Anya Chong-George is enthusiastic about the task.
One of the things I really love about journalism is that you are constantly learning. So the opportunity to learn and to do something so like in-depth is really, really exciting. Pretty much we're like being put out of our comfort zone and given such an important project. So I think having that opportunity to make a difference, I guess, spread awareness, which I think is definitely one of the main goals as a journalist you could ever have, to inform people.
Anya says getting the chance to meet with some who were on board at the time is valuable.
I think it's one thing to read something from a textbook, to actually seeing them face to face, hearing from them firsthand what the experience is like, how they felt, what happened, you know. I think it's a completely different experience to just reading it.
Also majoring in journalism, Mabel Muller is looking forward to taking part.
I think it's awesome. I think further on in the future, I'd be able to look back and say, oh my gosh, I was part of that 30. Like, imagine the 50th and looking back and saying, oh, actually they had a 30th and I was part of it. So yeah, I think it's a really good learning experience, and it's going to be a really good opportunity for us to grow as learning future journalists, I guess.
She says as a Pacific student, this event is also significant.
I think that Pacific people that live in New Zealand have, you know, an influence back home, because, you know, people back home look up at us like, oh, they live in New Zealand, they get all these advantages living there. And so I think it's important for us to be informed so that we could inform them. Yeah, I guess it hasn't personally affected me, but you know, I am from Pacific Islands, and it has something to do with the Pacific Islands. So, yeah, I think that makes it all the more important for me to know more about it.
New Zealand is quite a small country, and so for them to stand up against this kind of thing was really, really significant. And I think it's quite important for the Pacific nations to know that they don't have to be, you know, like manipulated or forced into something that they don't believe in.
Both think opportunities like this are important for journalism students to jump into, for experience and to inform others.
For me, it's more about experiencing it and learning and growing as a journalist, and like, okay, that's how that goes. I think if I didn't know this as a journalist, how much more so do other people who don't, you know, who aren't open to like this kind of work and things. And so I think it's really important.
I think also because now, obviously, with climate change and all that kind of thing, like, environmental issues are such a huge talking point at the moment. So definitely, like, the next generation should really be aware of this. And I wish I had learned more about it when I was in school. So, yeah, it's great to get the opportunity to actually learn now.